Greens will be calling for the protection and support of the workplace rights of temporary and contract teachers, and we ask this council to consider those rights of our very hard-working and long-serving teachers when voting on this bill. Should this bill pass in its current form, then temporary and contract teachers may well find themselves in a truly concerning situation. Under Schedule 3, Other Budget Measures Part 1, Amendment of Education Act 1972, this government is proposing to retrospectively reduce contract teachers' statutory right to long service leave entitlements. These entitlements have been established by the highest court in this country, the High Court of Australia, in AEU versus DEX case of 2012. The clause, if passed, will retrospectively reduce contract teachers' statutory right to long service leave. This is completely unacceptable, and the Greens strongly oppose this move, which we are surprised to see come from a Labor state government. A Labor government that claims to support working South Australians, and yet here is undermining their statutory entitlements and defying indeed the High Court in that bid. This move by the Wetherill government follows similar attempts made by former Treasurer Kevin Foley under the then Rann Labor government to reduce all public sector workers' long service leave entitlements. The AEU, the Australian Education Union of South Australia, took this matter to the highest court in the country in 2012 when it was ruled that temporary or contract teachers had the same rights to long service leave entitlements as permanent teachers, as they were deemed to be officers of the education service. The High Court there ruled that the minister was unauthorised to appoint temporary teachers under Section 9(4) of the Education Act 1972, as the subsection 9(4) was repealed in 2007 and replaced by Section 101(b)(1). The High Court of Australia papers in AEU versus DEX 2012, HCA 3, 29th of February 2012, raised the questions that I now quote. Did Section 9(4) of the Education Act 1972, at the time that it was in force, authorise the Minister to appoint officers to be engaged as teachers? Or did Section 15 of the Act provide exclusively for the appointment of teachers? The Court ruled, and I quote, Section 9(4) of the Education Act 1972, at the time that it was in force, did not authorise the Minister to appoint officers to be engaged as teachers, and Section 15 of the Act provided exclusively for the appointment of teachers. This question was raised because the long service leave entitlements of officers and employees appointed under Section 9(4) were less favourable than the entitlements enjoyed by officers of the teaching service appointed under Section 15. For instance, under Section 15, officers of the teaching service can break their service by up to 2 years and accrue long service leave for days worked. Whereas prior to the High Court decision, contract teachers had only 3 months under repealed subsection 9(4). The disputed question of whether or not it is open to the Minister to appoint persons as teachers under subsection 9(4), noting that this subsection was repealed in 2007 as it was replaced by Section 101(b) of the Act, is valid. The then Vice President of the South Australian branch of the Australian Education Union wrote to the then Minister responsible for the Act in May 2003, concerned about the Minister's appointment of contract teachers under Section 9(4) of the Act. On 21st of February 2005, the Director of Human Resources and Industrial Relations Services at the Department of Education wrote to the union advising that in future contract teachers would be known as temporary teachers and temporary relieving teachers would be appointed under Section 15 of the Act on a temporary basis. So here the department acknowledged the union's concerns and changed its practice and appointed temporary teachers under Section 15 of the Education Act. We know that since 2005 the teachers union and the department have been in dispute over the appointment of temporary and contract teachers, leading to the High Court case in 2012, where, as I said, that case was found in favour of the Australian Education Union and on behalf of those members. This proposed legislative change in this government's budget measures bill is an attack on a union's win for teachers who deserve their right to long service leave entitlements. The Greens stand proudly today with the union movement and with the teachers in calling on this Labor government to remove this retrospective attack on workers' rights. The category of teachers who will lose out because of the Wetherill government's long service leave amendment and attack include: one, women who, employed before 1986, had to resign because they were taking time off for childbirth and child rearing, and therefore broke their service for a period of longer than 3 months. Current contract teachers who have taken leave of longer than 3 months because they didn't know of the maternity leave provisions. Three, anyone who's ever been on a contract as a teacher and who, for whatever reasons, has had a break in service of longer than 3 months and less than 2 years. That is, those who don't have secure employment, predominantly women, who have had a break, often for child rearing and family responsibilities. They will be the ones who are discriminated against here in this budget measures bill. And they are already amongst the most vulnerable employees in the workforce. I would like now to address some of the remarks made by others in regards to this amendment I seek to make to this bill. It's the Australian Education Union's strong view that DECT and the government were aware that temporary teachers should arguably have been employed under Section 15 of the Act as officers of the teaching service, yet they persisted in questionable employment practices to deny that entitlement, despite the repeated protestations of the union. There were remarks made about how the teachers' long service leave entitlements would be calculated. I've been advised that if teachers only worked the quoted 1 week per year, any long service leave entitlements would be minimal, as it is, of course, accrued on a day's work pro rata basis. So I certainly agree with the Australian Education Union that that particular line of argument against the Greens amendment and against the Australian Education Union's plea here is a furphy. The Attorney-General stated to the Australian Education Union that the estimated cost of the High Court's decision would be, and he was quoted by the Education Union as saying to them, $100 to $200 million to ensure that contract and temporary teachers were provided their long service leave. However, the attorney has not demonstrated how that costing was calculated. The Australian Education Union believes that all records of temporary relieving teachers, TRT, days worked are centralised. TRT days do not attract long service leave, but do trigger continuity of service for long service leave accrual for temporary contract work undertaken. Now, before I conclude my remarks, I would like to go to some of the questions that the Teachers' Union would like to be answered by the government in this debate. Those questions are: why did the government seek to subvert the High Court decision by retrospectively altering employees' long-standing entitlements to long service leave? Why does the government seek to differentiate between permanent and non-permanent teachers? They are both classified as the quoted officers of the teaching service under the Education Act 1972. Why equate these members of the teaching profession with, and I quote, other public sector employees? And finally, which of those current employees whose long service leave entitlements will be reduced and possibly removed by this retrospective legislation? What information does the government have about the numbers of those particular teachers, and indeed if other demographic data? My understanding from what I've been told by the union is many of these are not only, as I've said, women, and that is unsurprising given the teaching profession, but indeed older women nearing retirement age, many of whom in fact who have had their superannuation significantly depleted as a result of the global financial crisis impact, many of whom I understand are in fact continuing to teach even though they would in fact like to now be entering retirement. And they are doing so because financially they cannot afford to do otherwise. In conclusion, Mr. President, I reiterate, this is a retrospective attack on teachers' long service leave. These entitlements, duly earned by those teachers, and this attack by a Labor government is unacceptable and inappropriate. This government claims to support South Australian workers, and yet here it is in this budget measures bill attacking those workers. Furthermore, I thank the Honourable John Daly and the Honourable Kelly Vincent in their contributions so far for their support, and I look forward to further debating this amendment by the Greens to stand up for the workers, the teachers, who this Labor Wetherill government is attacking in this budget measures bill.